For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a mainstream motherboard with a high-end chipset from Gigabyte, the Gigabyte Z890 EAGLE WIFI 7, sporting support for Intel's latest Arrow Lake S Core Ultra 200S series of desktop processors. We'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. For those of you who are unaware, Intel announced its Arrow Lake S Core Ultra 200S series of processors and the accompanying Z890 chipset more than a week ago, and these products are launching for sale on 24th October 2024. Ahead of their availability at retail, we'll be taking a look at the Gigabyte Z890 EAGLE WIFI 7 that, as its name implies, sports the Z890 chipset and sits within the more mainstream EAGLE series of motherboard offerings by Gigabyte, where it places below the gaming and Aorus lineups and sits right above the UD series. As can be seen, the Z890 EAGLE WIFI 7 comes in a box that sports a black, blue, and orange colorway, with the EAGLE text splashed across the front. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna that sports the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug connector. We do also get two SATA 3 cables. And these are accompanied by a multilingual installation guide, as well as a regulatory information leaflet right here. In terms of the Z890 EAGLE WIFI 7's overall appearance, we see that Gigabyte has gone for a black and grey aesthetic, where it comes with an integrated I/O shield and grey heat sinks all around. There's nothing much going on over on the rear of the board. We don't get any fancy motifs like those that you tend to find on higher-end motherboards. Fans of built-in aesthetic LEDs on their motherboards will be pleased to note that the Z890 EAGLE WIFI 7 does indeed come with such LEDs, where we get them within the integrated I/O shield cover and beneath the chipset heatsink. As can be seen, we do also get an illuminated Game On text right here. The Z890 chipset has a single chip design, and the said chipset sits beneath this large passive heatsink right here. For M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte included full heatsink coverage for all four M.2 slots that the Z890 EAGLE WIFI 7 comes with. The VRM heatsinks for this board are pretty decently sized, and Gigabyte has included 14 plus 1 plus 2 power stages with 60 amp power phases. For memory support, the Z890 EAGLE WIFI 7 comes with 4 DDR5 slots with a dual tabbed design that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8800 standard when overclocked. It's worth noting too that the board supports clocked unbuffered DIMMs, the latest memory module type on the block that comes with a built-in clock driver chip so as to improve signal stability, thereby paving the way for higher memory operating frequencies. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header right next to the RAM slots, and further down, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A front panel header that supports up to 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. We do also get 2 USB 2.0 front panel headers along the bottom edge of the board, with each header providing support for 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports for a total of 4 ports. Some interesting features to highlight. Back at the top of the motherboard, we get a power button that allows end users to power on the PC. A reset button, also termed a multi-key button by Gigabyte, that can be reprogrammed from within the BIOS to serve other purposes. A Q-Flash Plus button that is to be used to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, as well as a set of status LEDs that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. Along the bottom edge of the board, we get a TPM header for an optional discrete Gigabyte TPM module, Thunderbolt headers that are to be used with an optional Gigabyte Thunderbolt add-on card, a clear CMOS header, as well as a reset header that can be hooked up to the front panel reset switch of your PC case. For expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0x16 slot that sports Gigabyte's PCIe UD slot X design to reinforce the slot for use with heavy graphics cards, and it even comes with an inner rubber lining to prevent scratches to your graphics card's PCB. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the PCIe Easy Latch Plus feature that helps make removing a graphics card from the slot less of a painful affair. We do also get two full-length PCIe 4.0x16 slots that each operate at X4 mode. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with a single PCIe 5.0x4 M.2 slot and three PCIe 4.0x4 M.2 slots. Do note that of the two PCIe 4.0x4 M.2 slots that are wired to the Z890 chipset, only this slot here, M2M_SB, supports either a M.2 SATA or NVMe drive. The other three M.2 slots support NVMe drives only. That said, the board's M.2 heatsinks feature a toolless design called M.2 Easy Latch Click, which makes removing and installing the heatsinks really easy. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is M.2 Easy Latch Plus, which makes installing and removing M.2 drives a toolless affair like so. For audio, Gigabyte has included an entry-level Realtek ALC 897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of a Realtek RTL 8125D chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. Do note that different board revisions of the Z890 EAGLE Wi-Fi 7 come with different Wi-Fi 7 modules. For revision 1.0, which is what I have here in this video, it comes with a MediaTek MT7925B22M Wi-Fi 7 module that supports the 160MHz channel and serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. Revision 1.1, on the other hand, comes with a Realtek RTL8922AE Wi-Fi 7 module that also supports the 160MHz channel and comes with Bluetooth 5.4 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with six fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are three Gen 2 addressable RGB headers and a single 12-volt RGB header located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the Z890 EAGLE Wi-Fi 7 goes for an integrated I/O shield design, where the said I/O shield also comes with ventilation openings like so. The board comes with four USB 2.0 Type-A ports, two USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports with this port here supporting the Q-Flash Plus feature, a DisplayPort 2.1 port that supports a maximum display resolution of up to 3840 by 2160 at 144Hz, a USB 4 Type-C port that supports the DisplayPort alternate mode with support for a maximum display resolution of 3840 by 2160 at 144Hz, 3 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new Wi-Fi Easy Plug design, and your usual audio jack connectors. To sum up, the Z890 EAGLE Wi-Fi 7 is clearly targeted at the mid-range consumer, where it serves up a good mix of modern features. We get a decent VRM setup that should perform well with higher-end Core Ultra 200S processors, PCIe 5.0 support for a graphics card and M.2 drive, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, a USB 4 port, and a good assortment of USB connectivity options, rounded off by quality of life features such as PCIe Easy Latch Plus, M.2 Easy Latch Click, and so on. That said, it's worth noting that the Wi-Fi 7 module on this motherboard doesn't support the 320MHz channel for faster wireless connectivity. Something to note, especially if your intention is to use a high-speed Wi-Fi 7 router for your wireless internet needs. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.